Welcome to the Daily Dad Podcast, where we provide one lesson every day to help you with your most important job, being a dad. These are lessons inspired by ancient philosophy, by practical wisdom, and insights from dads all over the world. Thank you for listening, and we hope this helps. This is the kind of coach you have to be. A father is a provider, a protector, a rule setter, a friend. They are an educator and an exemplar. They are also, whether their kids play sports or not, a coach, because we have to coach our kids through much in life. We coach them through new experiences, through the games of school and work and relationship, through life's challenges and troubles. This role of coach, as essential as it is difficult because of all the stereotypes we have of coaches. There's Mike Ditka, there's Phil Jackson, there's Lombardi, and there's Tom Izzo screaming in a kid's face on the way to victory. Which is best? What kind of coach should we be? We asked David Epstein, who we've raved about here before, and as expected, he gave us an interesting answer. Both through my own experiences and through reporting books and articles, he said, I think I've done a 180 on what I think is the central role of a coach. When I was young, I was into the in-your-face, rah-rah kind of coach. I thought that was pretty cool. I couldn't be further from that now. I notice even with editors, I want someone honest and calm since I don't need to be fired up. And if anything, more often I want to be calmed down. But overall, I think the role of a coach is someone who can't really tell you what to do, but more walks hand in hand as you figure out what works for you. And I think that includes finding your appropriate level of arousal for whatever you have to do. Some people have to be jacked up and others calm down for the same kind of performance. It has stuck with me how much of my time with my son is spent trying to titrate to the right level of arousal. Too many coaches and dads have just one note. They're the screaming coach, or the preoccupied with important things coach, or they're the disciplinarian coach, or they're the endlessly encouraging coach, or they're the overly permissive players coach. Life is too complicated for this approach to be sufficient. Different scenarios require different energy. Different teams require different coaches. Hell, sometimes different players on the same team require different coaches. As James Frey told us, you have to figure out how to be flexible, how to adjust, how to be with the scenario, what your kid on that day in that moment requires. That's what a great coach does. That's what being a dad is. You're listening to the Daily Dad Podcast, one meditation a day inspired to help you do your most important job, which is be a great father. These are meditations inspired by ancient wisdom, psychological research, and just great strategies from normal dads just like you. Thanks for listening.